vernier calipers. So this is an instrument which is used for measuring lens up to a greater degree of accuracy than what a normal ruler would permit. So this is like a ruler which has centimeter markings on one side and inch markings on the other. But we will focus on just the centimeter markings because we are working in the SI system. So if you wanted to measure any length, then, you know, usually if I wanted to measure the length of this pen, for example, then I would hold it against the ruler like this and then make sure that one end is kind of flush at zero and then be able to read the length of this pen from the ruler. You all know how that is done. But vernier caliper, this is a very interesting device because it takes the whole process of measurement one step ahead and you know, helps you measure things which can be as small as, let's say, 0.1 millimeters or even smaller. It could even be 0.05 millimeters. So this is the 10th of a millimeter. So the degree of accuracy is usually 10 to 20 times of what you would get using a normal ruler like this. So this is the construction of the vernier calipers. We will not bother about the inches scale. That's the scale on the top. Let us just focus on the centimeter and the millimeter scale. So this is called the main scale, MS. Main scale is this entire scale. So this main scale is usually marked, the markings are there in millimeters. So you have that's a zero mark, then 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter. And in between you have 10 divisions, which are 1 millimeter each. And this is, goes all the way to whatever the length of the vernier calipers may be. And then this is the scale written here in centimeters. This is in inches, this is in centimeters. There's a tiny unit written here, centimeter. And then this part is called the vernier scale, VS, this entire part. And this entire part can slide back and forth to the right or to the left, and I'll show you how very soon. But this part can slide, and these are called the jaws. So these jaws, which are marked one here, when you slide this vernier scale to the left, then the jaws are going to close, and the gap between jaws, between this one, this gap will become zero eventually when this point starts touching this point. And then if you move it to the right, then the jaws are going to expand and you are supposed to fit in some length or some object which you want to measure between the jaws, something like this here. Like, let's say I want to measure the diameter of this bolt. So I'm going to fit it between the jaws like this. So you slide the jaws out and then start sliding them back after putting the object here. Start sliding them back until the jaws hit the surface of the object, and then they are tight there. And this is like a locking nut. This is like a guide mechanism. So this is a guide on which this whole thing is sliding. And then if you tighten this nut, then the whole slide system kind of locks in place, and then it's not going to move to the left or right. So once you have closed the jaws and let it touch the surface of the object you want to measure, then you can tighten the screw and lock the vernier scale just so that accidentally it doesn't move while you're taking the reading. This knob is used for sliding it left and right. So this knob doesn't rotate, but this knob just gives you a grip on your thumb so you can slide it, push it against the knob and then slide the whole scale left and right. And of course, there is some kind of lithium grease or some kind of white grease or some lubrication in the guides here, so that the vernier scale slides freely without any without much friction. So then there are some markings on the vernier scale. Usually we'll start with 10 markings, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 10. The one shown here has 20 markings. So there's a little mark between 0 and 1, there's a little mark between 1 and 2. So effectively the markings are 20, even though they are numbered 1 to 10, or 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, 9, and then the last one is 10, which is again written as 0 for some reason. And then what these markings are on the vernier scale, we'll look at them shortly, but let's first understand the construction. Then you have the jaws, the internal jaws here, which are marked as point number 2 here, and they are used for measuring the internal diameter of an object. These are for measuring the length. Like I can put in a piece of metal, like a metal rod here, and then I can measure the length of this metal rod. These ones, they are used for measuring the internal dimension of something, typically like a cylinder, and you want to measure the internal diameter. And then this is number three here, and this is used for measuring the depth. So this is how the depth is going to be. And let's see how it looks. So these are the three possible measurements. This is measurement number one, where you are trying to measure the outside dimensions of this orange object, and you make the jaws close tight against that object. Then this is measurement number two, where you are, maybe this is a hole or this is like just a cavity inside this orange object, and you want to measure the width of this cavity, or maybe it's a hole and you want to measure the diameter. So then you close the jaws, slide them inside like this, and then open them until they are taut or tight against the walls, against the surface, the inner surface of this object. And then the reading which you are going to see how to read this, this reading will tell you what this dimension or this distance is, this distance. In this case, we are measuring this distance. And then lastly, we have the third type of measurement, which is a depth measurement. In this, we are trying to measure the depth of this cavity. How deep is it? And so you hold this face against the edge of the vernier calipers. And then as you slide the jaw to the right, this little piece of rod slides out. That is shown here. This whole rod slides out as you slide this thing. Because this rod, it is moving in a little groove inside this metal thing, metal scale. And if you see it from the back side, you will see that groove. And so this rod is actually connected to this entire sliding scale. So as the sliding vernier scale moves to the right, the rod is going to keep protruding out of the end here. So this is the construction. If you want, you can read these things. Number one, that is used for measuring external objects, outside jaws. Then number two are called inside jaws. Number three is called the depth probe. And then four is the main scale. So this entire thing is the main scale here, this 4 point. And then fifth is the inch scale, but we are not interested in that. Then six is the vernier scale. So this is the vernier scale. This we are going to see in detail now, how the vernier scale works. Why does it work? And then vernier was the name of the scientist who, or the engineer who invented this. And then seventh, six is like the vernier scale for centimeters, and then there could be a vernier scale on top also, if especially if you have inches measurement on the top. But that is only for inches. So those two we ignore. We are not interested in inches right now. If nothing else, inches doesn't have 10 divisions. It has 8 divisions, and that just makes things not very metric for us. And then eighth is this point here. So either you have this little piece, and then there could be little, you know, knurling here. Knurling is a technical word. Knurl means something like you have some kind of grooves on this surface which provide a good grip on your thumb. So if you push your thumb right here, and then you can have a grip, and then you can slide the scale left and right. So this knurled grip could look like that, or it could look like this also. So it's just something that makes your thumb easy to hold this thing. So let's now see why the vernier scale works and what is the physics behind it, or rather the math behind it. So look at this diagram below of that same vernier caliper, which I have replicated. And this bottom part is the vernier scale. This upper part is the main scale. This is the zero mark. This is 1 centimeter. This is 2 centimeter. And then these are the markings in millimeters. 1 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 3, 4, and so on. Now the vernier scale, it so happens that if I close the jaws, if I move the slide the vernier scale to the left and then make sure the zero goes against zero, then this is what you see. Now observe carefully. So the zero of the vernier scale, which is now half hidden, that is aligned with the zero of the main scale. And then the vernier scale is designed in such a way that 10 number, like in this diagram, it could be different and I'll tell you how. But in this diagram, the 10 vernier scale divisions, the 10 divisions on the vernier scale are coinciding or are equal to 10 minus 1 or 9 divisions on the main scale. So this is the basic principle of the vernier caliper, that any number m of vernier scale divisions equal some number m minus 1 of the main scale divisions. That is a basic trick of why this vernier caliper works and gives us an accuracy of up to 0.1 millimeter or even 0.05 millimeters. For the scale system shown here, it's going to be 0.1 millimeter. So what happens is this, that because you have 10 divisions on the vernier scale being equal to 9 divisions on the main scale, if you zoom this point, I'm going to zoom it a little and then see what happens. So as you can see, because the divisions are not exactly the same, you don't have 9 divisions on the vernier scale being equal to 9 divisions on the main scale. Therefore, there's a little bit of difference between the one of the main scale and one of the vernier scale. And this is the trick. This is the crux of the whole matter, that this difference will be what? This difference is going to be 0.1 millimeter in this case. Let's see why. Let me take a screenshot of this and then take this enlarged picture and then paste it into the other program, or I can just show it here also. So what I'm claiming is, let me pick this pen, make it thinner. So this is what I'm claiming, that this tiny distance, or rather if I extend that upper line from the main scale, then this tiny distance, that is, suppose I call it x, all right, then this is going to be 2x because all the divisions are equal. So this distance will be 2x, and similarly this distance will be 3x. Similarly, this distance will be 4x. So all the way up to this point. So we have, let me count all these distances, 1x, and then 2x, and then 3x, then 4x, then 5x, then 6x, 7x, and then 8x, and then 9x. So this last one is going to be 9 times x. And now, so this is the distance between this and this. So actually x is the difference between one main scale division minus one vernier scale division, that equals x. But the scale is designed in such a way that it's always that m number of vernier scale divisions equal m minus 1 number of main scale divisions, because in this case m happens to be 10. So 10 vernier scale divisions are equal to 10 minus 1 or 9 main scale divisions. And if we use this, then we get 1 vernier scale division equals m minus 1 divided by m main scale divisions. And that comes out to be 1 minus 1 over m main scale divisions. So this x value will be what then? This x value, therefore, x is going to be equal to 1 main scale division. I'll just write it as 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. And that we have found to be this, 1 minus 1 over m main scale divisions. So MSD is common. 1 and 1 cancel out. This 1 cancels out with this. And we are left with 1 minus minus is plus. That is 1 over m. That's all. So we have found the value of x, that this tiny thing, this little difference, is going to be equal to the value of a main scale division divided by this number m. Where what was the number m? Number m was coming from this equation here, that this is the number m, the number of vernier scale divisions, which equal m minus 1 main scale divisions. So in this, using this trick, we have somehow created a way of measuring this tiny distance x, which in this case, in our example, let me change the color. In our example, we have 1 main scale division is simply 1 millimeter. So be careful, don't confuse the m with millimeter. Like m is just a pure number. It is an integer, it is a whole number. So 1 main scale division had a value of 1 millimeter. So I'm going to get the value of x as 1 millimeter divided by m happens to be 10 in our case. So 1 by 10 is going to be, that is going to be 0.1 millimeter. So this specific vernier caliper which I am showing you, this can, in this little difference in the main scale and vernier scale divisions, that difference is 0.1 millimeter. And now let's see how we are able to measure this tiny distance. So let us paste that diagram here, just in case if we need it, then we have it handy. So then we go back to that sliding diagram. Now we start sliding the vernier scale to the right. Suppose I have a little piece of wire and I fit that piece of wire between the two jaws and I slide it just enough that this comes in front of this. So remember the difference between these two lines. The difference between these two lines was initially x 0.1 millimeter. But now I have put wedged a little piece of wire, a thin copper wire, in between the jaws. And let's assume the thickness of the wire is exactly such that the jaws move to the right. The vernier scale moves slides to the right by an exact amount equal to x, so that these two lines are now in front of each other. So the division number 1 on the vernier scale is exactly in front of the division number 1 on the main scale. Then can you claim that the thickness of that wire which is wedged between the jaws must be x, or it must be 0.1 millimeter? So this is the mechanism which allows us to measure something so small, something so thin as 1/10 of a millimeter. If I had more divisions here, suppose my m whole number was not 10, suppose it was 20. Suppose I have 20 divisions on the vernier scale coinciding with 19 divisions on the main scale, and one division on the main scale is still 1 millimeter, then I would have had 20 vernier scale divisions equals 19 main scale divisions, and that would have given me one vernier scale division is 19 by 20, or x in that case would have come out to be 1 over 20 millimeter. So 1/20 of a millimeter would have been the thickness of this wire wedged between the jaws if one of MS main scale was right in front of one of vernier scale. Okay, now I'm going to slide this out a little bit. Suppose, now since these two right now are in front again, so I again have to take a screenshot of this to show you what I'm trying to say. So this is a very tricky matter, but you know, you have to understand it only once. So let me explain it again here. So now what I'm claiming is that this gap is now equal to x, or 0.1 millimeter, which in our case is 0.1 millimeter. Now, if I slide this out further, let's assume that now I have a piece of wire wedged between the jaws that is 2x, or 0.2 millimeters. Then what would happen? Okay, since these two are already lined up with each other, this gap now must be x, because initially this gap was 2x, because this is in front of 2. And now we have moved the jaw to the right by already x here. So this gap must now be x again. So if I further move it by x, then this gap is going to close. And then this gap between the jaws is now going to become 0.2 millimeters. So in that situation, we are going to have this vernier scale division coinciding with this division of the main scale, because this is going to move to the right by an amount equal to x, and so these two are going to line up. Similarly, if I had a piece of wire which was 3x thick, then this would have moved out another x further, and this line would have become opposite this line. In that case, a vernier scale division number 3 would have coincided with this line on the main scale. And similarly, if you go with 4x, then you further shift it, and then this line is going to line up with this line. So this is the trick. This is the basic principle on which vernier caliper works. So I'm going to now slide it out. So just watch carefully what is happening here. I'll keep sliding it out. So these now divisions on the main scale, for a moment, they don't matter, as long as you just keep track of what is going on here. So I'm just zooming this out, and then I slide it. So now I have opened the jaws by a total distance of 2x. And as you can see, these two lines are opposite each other. Further, I go out And now these two lines are against each other. So the gap between the jaws must be now 3x, because vernier scale division number 3 is now lined up with this main scale division. Then I slide it out further. Now these two are coinciding or lined up against each other. So the jaws, the gap between the jaws must now be 4 times x. Now this x seems to be a very important quantity. So we are going to give this a name. So this x, we are going to give it a name. And that name is shown in the formula here. So let's suppose that m vernier scale divisions coincide with m minus 1 main scale divisions. So m could be 10. So 10 of these coincide with 9 of these. So they must be equal because they represent the same distance. Or m could be 20. Then you have 20 coinciding with 19 of those. Usually more than 20 is difficult to read. So either you have just 10, or in the more expensive ones, you have 20. And then, of course, you have digital vernier calipers also, where everything is just read digitally. Or there could be needles which kind of go around like a clock. But we are not interested in those. In our exams, we will only be getting things like this, these kind of vernier calipers, which are old-fashioned vernier calipers. So m is that important number. So in our example, this is 10. It could be 20 also. So if m vernier scale divisions are equal to m minus 1 main scale divisions, then one vernier scale division is m minus 1 over m main scale divisions, which is 1 minus 1 over m, as we saw. Then we define something called the vernier constant, and that is also the least count of the instrument. So what is least count? Least count of any instrument is the smallest measurement which that instrument can measure, the smallest value of the physical quantity for which that instrument is designed to measure. So, for example, a galvanometer or an ammeter or a voltmeter are designed to measure physical quantities from the chapter of electricity. Like a voltmeter will measure voltage between two points. And an ammeter would measure the current flowing through a certain wire. So, in every meter or in every instrument, every measuring device, there are certain calibrations. You have certain markings, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you have some units. If you are using a vernier calipers, then the units could be in millimeters. If you have a meter scale, it could be in centimeters or millimeters also. If you have an ammeter, then 1, 2, 3, 4 calibrations would be in amperes, which is the unit of current. For voltmeter, it's going to be in volts, and so on. So every instrument that is used to measure a physical quantity has some kind of calibrations or some kind of a scale with the appropriate unit there. So least count is the smallest value of that physical quantity which that instrument can measure. So that is the least count of that specific instrument. And in our example, we just saw that the thinnest thickness of wire, the smallest thickness of wire you can measure using this vernier caliper is going to be X, or 0.1 millimeter. So that X we call the least count of this instrument. And in case of vernier caliper, that X is called the vernier constant. So X is called the vernier constant, and it also happens to be the least count of this vernier caliper because that's the smallest thing you can measure. And that we saw earlier why it is one main scale division minus one vernier scale division. And we just solved that. It comes out to be 1 over M times the value of one main scale division. So if the main scale division is 1 millimeter, M has a value of 10, then your least count or vernier constant will come out to be 1/10 of a millimeter or 0.1 millimeter. And then the value of length is read like this. The value of this is the main master formula which tells you the actual reading. So if you want to find the length of anything that is wedged between the jaws, external or internal or the depth gauge, whatever it is, then this is how you read it. It is capital N plus small n into the vernier constant, where capital N is the main scale reading on the left of 0 on the main scale. And I'll just explain to you what that is. Small n is the vernier division number which coincides with any one of the main scale divisions. And then zero error, I'll talk about that later. So let me again zoom this further and show you what is going on. So suppose now, right now, what is coinciding? Let's see. So I have moved this out sufficiently so that the fourth vernier scale division is now coinciding with this. So let's say I keep doing that and I cross this one mark. Let's say I'm I first come exactly at the 1 mark. So my zero of the vernier scale is exactly in front of this 1 millimeter. So as you can see, this distance between the jaws right now is exactly 1 millimeter. I hope you can see that from the diagram itself, that this distance between the jaws is exactly 1 millimeter, the value of the main scale division. Then I move it out further, and let's say I just move it out by an extra amount x. So now this line is coinciding with this division number 1. So can you now understand that this distance between the jaws must be 1 millimeter plus x, or 1.1 millimeter? Because this 1 is already there, and then I have moved out an extra distance x. Then I move out another x, and now my vernier scale division number 2 is coinciding with the main scale division. So which main scale division coincides doesn't matter. You only have to focus on the vernier scale division, which is coinciding with any main scale division. So I might as well hide this, but I can't hide it because I need to see what this 1 is here. Because, you know, if I, for instance, if I keep moving out, and let's say I now come to this point. So my 0 is exactly in front of 2. So I hope you can see that this distance now between the jaws is exactly 2 millimeters. So I need to see this 2 mark. Besides that, I might as well hide it. I don't need that. But once I see this 2 mark, after that, if I go out another x, so this now must be, this difference must be x now. So I go out further by an amount x, so this gap closes. And these two lines come in front of each other. Now I can say that my gap between the jaws must be 2 millimeters, which was this, plus the extra distance that I moved, which was x. And why x? Because division number 1 of the vernier scale is coinciding with some main scale division. All right. So my length L wedged between the jaws must be equal to 2 millimeters plus 1, which is the vernier scale division number coinciding with some main scale division, multiplied with the vernier constant, which in our case happens to be equal to x, which is 0.1 millimeters. So now my length must be 2 millimeter plus 0.1 millimeter. And so that answer is 2.1 millimeters. So what would happen if I moved it out further? Let's say I took the same thing and I moved it out by another distance x. Then this division number 2 is going to coincide because I'm going to close this gap. So I start moving it. Now it's exactly aligned in front of here. So this division number 2 is now aligned in front of some main scale division. Again, I'm not interested in that, so I hide it. So this time my gap is going to be what? It is going to be equal to 2 millimeters plus twice of x. So 2.2 millimeters. So I can keep doing this. I can slide it out as much as I want, but the general formula is now going to become that this number here is simply the main scale division number to the left of the zero of the vernier scale. So this line is the zero of the vernier scale. So you find the main scale division number, which is just to the left of the zero of the vernier scale. So let's call that capital N. And then you have this number is small n, which is the vernier division number that coincides with some division on the main scale. And then you have simply the vernier constant here. So this is the formula that is given below now. So vernier constant, I've already told you, 1 over m into main scale division value. So the value of a length is capital N plus small n into VC, where capital N is the main scale reading on the left of 0 on the main scale. And small n is the vernier division number which coincides with any one of the main scale divisions. And the zero error we'll see after this, but let us do a few examples to understand this formula and kind of commit it to our memory and see how it works. But I hope you have understood the concept behind the vernier scale, that how intelligently Mr. Vernier designed this scale, and he kind of, you know, put in a difference of 1 division, and that difference kind of got carried or spread across the entire vernier scale of 10 divisions. And that's how you got such a tiny little measurement. So let's do some examples. All right, so I have this example here. in which this is some piece of metal, some rod of metal, and the jaws are closed around it, and we want to find what is this length equal to. So now watch carefully. In this case, this is the division number, and I'll circle it. The vernier scale division number 6 is coinciding with some main scale division. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times we have moved over and above the division number 7. So from the main scale division of 7 millimeter, we have moved an extra distance of 6 into x, or 6 into the vernier constant. So the length L must be n plus small n into VC. In this vernier scale, you had 10 divisions of vernier scale coinciding with 9 divisions of main scale. So one vernier scale division is 0.9 millimeters. And then the least count or the vernier constant or the x value, simply the difference between a main scale division and a vernier scale division. So that we have already found to be 0.1 millimeter in this case. So what is the answer then? Well, you already have 7 here. So this n carries the units. Now be careful about that. N is small, n is simply the number. That is a whole number reading from this scale here. So this scale doesn't have any units. These are just pure numbers. But the scale on top has the units of centimeter or millimeter. You have to see appropriately, like this is 1 centimeter. Then accordingly, this must be 1.2 centimeters, 1.3 centimeters and so on. So this n comes with the units. This capital N should carry the units. So in this case, this is the seventh division on the main scale, which is to the left of the zero of the vernier scale. So I have 7, and not just 7, it is 7 millimeter. I have to see what this division represents along with its units, because the main scale divisions have units. The vernier scale divisions just have pure numbers. I mean, you can assign units to them, you know, using this formula, but what's the point? Plus, small n in this case is what? It is number 6. 6 into 0.1 millimeter. So both are in millimeters, therefore you can add them directly, and the answer is going to be 7.6 millimeters. And even from your common sense, I'm sure, you can feel that this distance is about 0.6 millimeters. This is full 1 millimeter, so this is around 0.6. Alright, so this is how it works. Let us now do some more problems, and then we'll see what the zero error is. So zero error can come in if there's a damage to the jaws, or after repeated use, these jaws have become kind of, there is a wear and tear, and so the metal, a layer of metal has worn off. And so when you close the jaws, this zero, instead of coinciding with this zero here, it actually overshoots to the left by maybe 0.1 millimeter. Or in the other case, you might have developed some rust on the jaws. And even when you close the jaws against the rod, that little layer of rust adds an extra thickness to it. So when you close the jaws with nothing in between, the zero doesn't come right in front of the zero of the main scale. Instead of now overshooting on the left hand side, it stays somewhere on the right hand side, because there's a some kind of rust thickness layer in between. So those are the two zero errors that are created. One is called the positive zero error, the other is called the negative zero error, and we'll see soon how to tackle those. But let's see some more problems based on this. So in this example, the jaw is already opened up to this point 1 here, and then opened up further by some small distance. And what is this mark here? This mark must be 2.1 centimeters. So 2 centimeter plus 1 millimeter. And then we have to see how much extra has been opened up. So how much extra has this red arrow moved from this one mark to the right? So this little distance. So this must be, let's see which reading is coinciding. I'm just going to highlight it. This is the one that's coinciding, reading number 3. Now sometimes no reading will coincide perfectly. In that case, you just choose the one that is closest to coinciding. And I'll show you that example also. So what must be this length now? This length between the jaws? This length must be capital N plus small n into vernier constant. Vernier constant for this vernier caliper, we already know it is 0.1 millimeter. So this must be capital N is what? It is the reading to the left of the zero of the vernier scale. And that reading is 2.1 centimeter. Or you can even call this 21 millimeters. It's up to you. Just don't make a mistake in the values, because This is going to be in millimeter, so it's better you keep this also in millimeter so you don't make a mistake. Plus, small n is what? Small n is number 3 here into vernier constant is 0.1 millimeter, and that will give you 21.3 millimeters or 2.13 centimeter. So this must be the gap between the jaws for whatever is the length of the object that is wedged between the two jaws. So this is very interesting. Like, you know, I mean, today we might find it very easy, but somebody who invented this principle first, hundreds of years ago, it's a remarkable feat that at that point in time, you could measure things as small as, let's say, 1/20th of a millimeter or 0.05 millimeters. And then there's also another device that's called the screw gauge, which can go even further. It can go up to 1/100th of a millimeter or even less. So we will see that next, but let us first do the zero error of the vernier caliper in the next video.